Okay, let's talk about cleaning your respirator. It's vitally important and it's OSHA required to clean your respirator on a regular basis. But before we talk about how to clean a respirator, let's talk about what happens if you don't clean your respirator. It's extremely important. First of all, you've worn your respirator a couple of days and then you set it down, which is incorrect. You don't just sit it down and walk off. You have to clean your respirator. What happens if you don't? Well, let's just say a week from now you put your respirator on, or 2 weeks from now, all of that bacteria from your breath and the particulates from your mouth, the Big Mac, the mucus, the boogers, yes, I'm grossing you out, I know, but that bacteria has babies. And then you put your respirator back on a week from now and you had never cleaned it. Well, then you start to inhale through this respirator. And you're getting all of that bacteria potentially in your lungs and sinus cavities and so forth, which could promote disease. So it goes without saying, it is vitally important and it is required to clean your respirators. Now, how do you clean your respirators? There's several different ways. First of all, the daily cleaning. Your company is required to have respirator wipes, which they can purchase. I don't know the chemical composition. I think they have lanolin in it, and I think they have antibacterial agents in the respirator wipe. But you are to clean your respirator after each usage. What do you clean with a respirator wipe? Well, certainly you need to pull this out and get into the crevices of the respirator, and then all over the inside of the respirator. This is your daily cleaning that you're supposed to do. Now, there's another more invasive cleaning that you do. When you do that cleaning, you need to take the straps off. They just unsnap. I won't do it here, but you can see that they just unsnap. They're flexible. You need to take out the little rubber pieces on the inside, okay, right there. Just pull those out. Save all these parts. You'll have to put it back together. Take out these exhalation ports and inhalation port. And then we mix up 90% water and 10% bleach. Don't go more than 10% bleach, because bleach is corrosive and it can damage the overall respirator. All we're wanting to do is kill germs, bacteria, viruses. So 10% bleach is sufficient. Scrub it down real good, gently. Leave it in the bleach 4, 5, 6 minutes. And then when you are done and it's totally, all the parts have been cleaned, and incidentally, you do never put your filters into the bleach. These stay dry and separated. But once you have cleaned and put together your respirator, then you want to take some paper towels and blot dry it, and then put your respirator out to air dry for a little while. Put it back together. Now, when you do this, it's a clean respirator. You need 2 gallon Ziploc bags. On one of the bags, write clean respirator. On the other bag, write cartridges. And the reason is very important. You always want a clean respirator to go in that Ziploc bag. And you don't want to confuse it with dirty cartridges the next time. That's why you label it face piece. Or respirator, and the other one is labeled cartridges. So the clean face piece goes in the Ziploc bag and it's zipped. Bacteria won't get in it now. Now, we don't want to throw away our cartridges every day, our cartridge filters. These cost money and it may still be good. Nothing wrong to wear it again as long as you don't taste anything, smell anything, or it's difficult to pull air through. So we want them to go into the Ziploc gallon bag labeled cartridge filters, and then you can store them correctly. Don't put a book or anything on the top of it, or any weight. It might distort the shape of the face piece. Make sure you clean your cartridge filter, make sure you clean your respirator after each usage.